Hi guys, welcome to this 12th tutorial in this series of programming PEEK microcontroller with MicroC Pro for PEEK compiler. This is part 2 of the automatic temperature control system project. In part 1, we designed the circuit diagram. In this part, we're gonna write our code. Let's go to MicroC and start a new project. Click on New Project. We're going to use the new project wizard. Next, we're going to name our project temperature control, temp control. Browse the location where you're going to save your project. You're going to store in automatic temp folder. Click OK. Select the device that you're going to use. We're going to use the PEEK 18F45K22. Select the device clock. We're going to use 32 megahertz. Click Next. You're not going to add any file to our project. Next. Include all the default. Next. Open Edit Project to configure to set our configuration bit. Finish. This is our configuration bit. We're going to select the HS oscillator because we're going to use an external crystal oscillator of 8 MHz, which is within 4 and 16 MHz. We're gonna enable our PLL because our 8 MHz times 4 is gonna give us 32 because we're gonna work on 32 MHz. The other thing that we're gonna need, we're gonna leave basically everything on their default values. Our MCLR pin is enabled. Click OK. We're just going to write some few comments. It's always good to write some few comments about your project. The name of our project is Automatic Temperature Control. The MCU that we're going to use is PEEK 18F45K22 and the oscillator frequency is 32 MHz. The first thing that we're going to do is our connection, which is going to be our keypad. We're going to specify where we're going to connect our keypad. And our LCD display. Our LCD display is connected to port C and our keypad is connected to port B. As we have learned from interfacing a keypad to PEEK microcontroller, you have to specify this variable character keypad port, specify where you're gonna connect your keypad. We're gonna connect our keypad to port B. And this is our LCD connection. The RS pin of the LCD is connected to port C, bit 4. The enable is connected to port C, bit 5. And the data lines are connected from bit 0 to bit 3. This is how you connect your LCD as you have learned it from the LCD tutorial. To make our code neat and readable, we defined a label name heater, which is connected to port D, bit 0. Another label is named fan, which is connected to port D, bit 1. The enter of our keypad to specify when we press our enter, its value is gonna be 15. Our clear is gonna be 13. We've got a label on, which has a value of 1, and the label off, which has a value of 0. So in our code, instead of writing port D 0, we're just gonna write heater or fan. And when we are reading the status of our keypad to find out that an enter key have been pressed, instead of writing 15, we're just gonna write enter. And when we want to clear, we're gonna write clear. And when we want to switch on our fan or heater, or switch it on or off our fan or heater, then we're gonna write on or off. This is gonna make our code really clean and readable. Now, let us create some few variables that we're gonna use in this project. The first variable is unsigned short keyboard and text. We're gonna use another unsigned short for a reference temperature. We're gonna have an assigned character for temperature. When we are displaying our temperature to the LCD, we're gonna have unsigned int temperature to read our temperature value. We're gonna have a float millivolt, and we're gonna have a float actual temperature. NCL C equals to 0 is to configure port C as a digital input output pin. It has to be digital because we're going to connect our LCD on port C. Port B has to be digital as well because we're going to connect our keypad. Port D, we set it, we configure it as a digital as well because it's where we're going to connect our heater and our fan. We didn't specify the port A to become analog, as by default, it's already an analog input pin. The trusted A bit 1 is to set the direction of pin RA0 to become an input pin. The trusted C sets port C as output pin. The trusted D bit 0 to set D0 as an output pin and D1 as an output pin to connect our fan. Now let us write some few code, a startup code, when we switch on our circuit. The first thing to do is to call the keypad init function to initialize our keypad and LCD init to initialize our LCD. You have to call this function whenever you are using a keypad or LCD, as you have learned from the keypad and the LCD tutorial. The first function of the LCD that we're going to use is to clear the screen. So whenever we start, we power on our circuit, we're going to clear the screen. This is the function to clear the screen, as we have learned it from the LCD tutorial. Then we're going to switch off the blinking cursor. And after that, we're going to display automatic on the first row of the LCD. And on the second row, we're going to display temp control. We're just going to display this automatic temp control for 2 seconds before we can start doing anything else. We're going to switch off our heater and we're going to switch off our fan. Let us build our project and see how it's going to be displayed on the LCD display. Build. The build successful. Right click. Project. This is going to be 8 megahertz. Browse. Open, run. You can see it says automatic temp control. Stop, let's continue with our code. The next code that we're gonna write is to prompt the user to enter the reference temperature. So basically after 2 second delay, we're gonna clear our screen and then we're gonna enter on the first line of the LCD, enter temperature reference. And on the second line, we're going to write temp ref equals 2. And here we're going to wait for the user to enter the reference temperature. Then we're going to create a while one loop. And this loop going to loop continuously until the enter key is pressed. Basically, once the enter key is pressed, we're going to break out from the loop and continue with our code. This variable is going to read the value of the keypad. This function waits until some key is pressed and released. And when this is released, the function is going to return 1 to 16, depending on the key that is pressed, because this library is used for a 4x4 keypad. So basically, whenever I pressed a key, this function is going to return the value of that key. If 1 was pressed, then it's going to return the value of 1. If the hash key was pressed, then it's going to return the value of 15 and so on. So we're going to say, while nothing is pressed, we're going to remain here. But if something is pressed, and that thing is the hash key, which is going to be represented, which is going to return the value of 15, then we're going to break out of the loop and continue with our code. But if it was not the enter key, then we'll have to store that value into our keypad variable. Because we are using a 3x4 keypad in our project, and this function is only used with a 4x4 keypad, we'll have to skip the last colon of the keypad. That's why we said if the keypad value that is received is greater than 3, but less than 8, we're going to minus 1. This is going to be the second row of our keypad. We have to minus 1 because we don't have the last colon of a 4x4 keypad. And we're going to say again, if the value that is received is greater than 8 but less than 12, then we're going to minus by 2. And if the value that is returned is 14, then our keypad variable is going to store 0. But if 13 is returned, which is basically our clear value, then we're going to go to start. And whenever we go to start, the first thing we do, we start again the whole process to clear the screen. So this is basically going to be to clear our screen and start again from scratch. Maybe you entered a wrong value and you want to start from scratch. Then you can press the clear value. This function is used to write a character at the current cursor position, so you don't have to specify the cursor position. Then our temp ref variable is going to be equals to 10 times the temp ref plus the value of our key that was pressed. So after we have pressed our enter key to validate the value of our reference temperature, then the LCD, we're going to clear our LCD. Then we're going to display the reference temperature. We're going to display to the LCD. This function into string is used to convert the integer value into a string so that we can be able to display on the LCD display. Because the temp reference is an integer value, we'll have to convert it into a string and store it in the text variable so that we can display it on our LCD display. Then we're going to display our reference temperature on the LCD display. And on the second line of our LCD display, we're going to say, press enter to continue. Basically, if you are happy with the reference temperature, then you're going to press enter to continue. Then we're going to start another while one loop. We're going to initialize our keyboard variable with 0. Then we're going to remain in this while one loop until the enter key is pressed. So we're just going to loop and read our keypad. If we press any other keys, we're just going to ignore those keys until an enter key is pressed. And once the enter key is pressed, then we're going to jump out of the loop. We're going to clear our screen. Then we're going to display on our LCD on the first line temp ref, and on the same line at the end, we're going to display the degree symbol. We use the character code of 223, which represent the degree symbol. But you must know that different LCD displays have different character code for degree, so you always have to check your LCD display datasheet. Then we're going to display the letter C for Celsius. Let us build our project again. Build. Let us run. Run. Gonna say automatic temp control for 2 seconds. Then it's gonna prompt the user to enter the reference temperature. I'm gonna write 12. Enter. Then you're gonna say the ref temperature is 12. Press enter to continue. Basically, it's looping and wait for me to press the enter key. Press. Then it's gonna say temp ref equals to, and at the end it's gonna write degree Celsius. This is all, guys, for this part 2. In the third part, which is gonna be our last part, we're gonna finish this project. And I'll see guys in part 3. Thank you.